Welcome to the channel. Today is the next in our SONOFF series where we review and configure all things SONOFF. Today we are looking at the SONOFF ZNSB-02P temperature and humidity sensor that was released in October 2023. It's the successor to the older SNZB-02, which is still for sale but for a discounted price. Links to both in the description. We'll run through what you get in the box, do a comparison against its older sibling, then we'll test connecting it with Home Assistant via ZHA and Zigbee2MQTT, and check out the performance to see if those claimed accuracy figures are accurate. Then we'll round up with a recommendation as to if you should buy it, upgrade to it, or skip it. So let's get hot and steamy and dive on in. In the box, you get the O2P, an orange powder-coated metal mounting plate, a screw and a double-sided sticker for mounting the plate, and a user manual. Link in the description to the manual, just in case you can't read the incredibly small writing. The O2P is made from good quality plastic. It's unclear as if it's UV resistant, but I've had mine outside in a covered, partially shaded area for 4 months, and it doesn't seem to have discolored. The device is circular and 45mm across by 18mm deep and weighs in at 15.5 grams and feels well engineered with respectable tolerance gaps. It has a pairing button located on the bottom of the unit and an air vent at the top. As such, even though it doesn't say it's outdoor rated, I would say not. On the front of the device at the top is a red LED to indicate pairing status that flashes when the pairing button is pressed. Inside the O2, the back cover has a powerful neodymium magnet to affix the unit to its metal mounting plate. Then there's the huge CR2477 battery that gives this device its amazing battery life. More on that later. The bright orange mounting plate is made of metal and for its size is a good weight, giving the feel of robustness and quality. It's powder coated so that it doesn't tarnish or degrade and gives a level of protection. It has a drilled hole in the center that you can use along with the included screw to mount, or you can use the double-sided sticker instead. By comparison with its older sibling, the O2P model is a comparable size and weight, but changes its form factor to a circular instead of the previous square, looking a lot more modern with increased build quality. The older O2 model uses a CR2530 button cell, compared with a much larger CR2477 that the O2 uses. There are no official figures that I have found in relation to the O2 and how long it will last on the battery. But the new O2P is reported to last for 4 years, making it the longest lasting battery-powered temperature and humidity sensor on the market that I'm aware of. Connectivity of the O2P is via Zigbee 3.0, giving it a distinct advantage over its older sibling that uses the previous generation of Zigbee. With better power management for longer lasting batteries, mesh networking, improved interoperability, and better security, the O2P comes with the Scilabs EFR32MG22 chip and the SDH40 sensor, which have excellent results. Although we don't have a sensor listing for the older O2 unit, but we'll be testing the sensor accuracy later on. The sensor is compatible with Amazon Alexa, Google Home and Home Assistant, working with ZHA and Zigbee2MQTT. To add to ZHA, navigate to Settings, Devices and Services, Add Integration, Add Zigbee Device. Press and hold the pairing button on the bottom of the device for 6 seconds. The O2 will appear, and after its initialization will report that it's ready for use. Optionally change the name of the device and give it an area. Within ZHA, the device will report sensors for temperature and humidity, under configuration that the firmware is up to date, under Diagnostics, the battery level, and an indicator, which when pressed will illuminate the front LED to signify the unit. Now before we add this to Zigbee2MQTT, remember to remove it from ZHA. Press the three dots and press remove and confirm with OK. To add the O2 to Zigbee2MQTT, I'll assume that you have already installed Zigbee2MQTT. If not, watch the video in the pop-up above and come back to this video. Navigate to Zigbee2MQTT in the left-hand menu. Turn on Permit to Join. Press and hold the pairing button on the bottom of the device for 6 seconds and then release. The pairing LED on the front will flash, indicating that the device is in pairing mode. The O2P will appear after its initialization and is ready for use. Optionally press the pencil to the right of the device to change the name. Make sure you toggle the switch to update the Home Assistant entity IDs. Now press Rename. To view the exposed entities, select the device. Press Exposed on the top menu. You can now see the entities that the device exposes. The battery level, the temperature, the humidity, a battery low indicator, a battery voltage, which shows as null, but we've only just added the device and will be updated later, and a link quality, which gives you a great indication for devices that are nearly out of range. This is a good time to quickly point out one of the advantages of Zigbee2MQTT. Pressing the settings specific brings up a calibration configuration for the device, where you can run the device in parallel with known accurate devices and adjust the temperature and humidity within the offset to make them read even more accurately. This is something you cannot do within ZHA without YAML coding. While you are adjusting the Zigbee calibration, maybe drop me a super thanks or buy me a coffee. It's really appreciated. To test the performance of the O2P, we'll be testing it side by side with an IKEA VindStyrka, which shows temperature and humidity along with other data, and a Wittboy Weather Station using its indoor temperature and humidity sensors connected to its base station. Now, I'm not saying either of these devices are super accurate, but it will give us a good comparison to similar devices. For the purpose of this test, we'll be using a Zigbee2MQTT for the O2, and all three devices are next to each other and undisturbed for 1 hour to allow them to reach their reporting temperatures and humidity levels. Now, the claimed reporting accuracy of the O2P is plus or minus 2% for humidity and plus or minus 0.2 degrees Celsius for temperature. I've plotted all three devices on the same graph for temperature and humidity to make it easier to visualize the relative measurements. The temperature for the O2 is virtually exactly the same as the Wittboy Weather Station, which is a good indication that the O2 is reporting the correct temperature and lives up to its accuracy of 0.2 degrees plus or minus. Humidity is far more difficult to measure accurately, hence the plus or minus 2 degrees accuracy range. Although the O2 reads 3.8% higher than the Wittboy Weather Station, this is an acceptable level of accuracy, as I can't confirm if the Wittboy figure is 100% accurate. As a side note, all three devices were graphed onto a dashboard using Plotty, which is a great card for information-rich graphs that can be created in seconds. Watch out for that video tutorial on that card. So what do I think of the SONOFF SNZB-02P? Well, it's well engineered and feels solid and robust in your hand and gives the impression that it will last. The change in design from the cheaper plastic square construction makes it a top choice on feel and looks alone. The inclusion of the quality metal mounting plate with both screw and 3M stickers is a great option and allows for ease of mounting and removal if required. I really like this type of mounting and think that other manufacturers should also include this. The battery life is nothing short of astounding. Even if it achieves 3 years of the battery life against its advertised 4 years, still makes this a standout feature that other manufacturers will be scrambling to match. Based on the limited performance I conducted, it achieved the reported levels of accuracy, at least the accuracy that I need for reporting and automations I require. So should you buy it, upgrade to it, or skip it? As it doesn't offer any new sensors or features, I don't believe it should be an upgrade. However, if you're in the market for an inexpensive temperature and humidity sensor, I think you should buy it. I don't know of a comparable sensor that offers the quality for the price. Links in the description. I hope you liked the video, and if so, consider subscribing and joining the ever-growing community. Hit that bell to be notified of the new released videos, and maybe a super thanks or buy me a coffee. It really does support the channel. Until the next one, don't get all hot and sweaty over picking a sensor again.